Com Cup champion in Ultra Street Fighter 4 with his Yun, and he brought a lot of that playstyle to his Cammy early on. The Rago DPs.
Rago. It makes sense to switch to Cammy in this game, considering his, you know, his playstyle in Street Fighter 4. I find it interesting that Goichi says he has a countermeasure for this kind of like crazy, aggressive, amazing reactions, fantastic reads style of play that Kazunoko brings to the table. I'm keen to see what that countermeasure is.
Goichi, another player here featuring in this top eight who made top four at Evo, so it's a good indicator how you do at Evo is how you can do in the Capcom Cup.
Yeah.
Aside from infiltration.
Unless you're infiltration, of course. That's the exception to that rule. Yeah. But you know, we've seen how unforgiving the game is. You know, that's all it is. It's just a case of your errors can haunt you very quickly in this game. We saw Yukodon have some amazing rounds there against Fudo. One or two errors and he was dead. That's just the way it goes. And you know, it just happened to be the case this weekend for some of the other players. We'll see here how this one pans out. Kazunoko,
a player you feel has maybe been overlooked throughout the year. I mean, he hasn't actually won any of the premier events. Third at the Japan Cup, fourth at the Asia Finals, third, of course, at Red Bull Kumite as well early on in the season, ninth place at Evo, and numerous top 16 finishes on the Pro Tour.
So the thing is, he's had a great season when you actually hear that.
Yeah.
But in comparison to where his Yon was in Street Fighter 4, it's not what we expected. You know, we know this guy is usually up there, you know, slinging, going back and forth with the very best. So he's been kind of just outside that very best. So yeah, you know, it's the blunt truth is it's a surprise that he's done so well to eliminate to send Fudo to losers so early on.
Goichi, one of those army of Japanese players that made the trip all across North America the first few months of the Pro Tour.
It racked up a ton of points, didn't
seventh well. Final round, of course, fourth at Evo, as I mentioned, came third in the G League in China, and that was really well contested as well.
Stacked.
Five top eights in ranking events as well. One loss to Ricky in the mirror match. That's why he's in loser's bracket right now.
We're off.
So here we go. Kazunoko, Ikami, Goichi, Chun-Li.
Some Japan on Japan crime. Allowing him to confirm there.
We saw early on Goichi going for the pressure and then just backing off, respecting.
I think he remembered who he was up to.
Exactly. Made me smile.
Kazunoko bringing it. Goichi being very patient.
Oh, great bait. That time, that respect does pay off. That hurts.
Wow, all that for a DP.
Activates.
Now hit confirm.
Goes takes the damage that time, I respect that.
Wake up.
Leech is legs. Gone.
Oh, MC's
oh, that was so smart.
Great choice there from Kazunoko.
Taiki characters can always get away with one or two empty jump lows.
Absolutely.
And he made it pay. He made it count there.
As they approach you in the air. Starts around with 4 meter though. Cammy on the opposite. Oh, nice anti-air choice here. Beautifully spaced. Another good start to the round here from Goichi. Seeing how quickly that can deteriorate here as Cammy activates.
Goichi looking to activate as soon as possible. See a lot of other Cammies sometimes wait for the confirm.
Kazunoko, just do it again. Beautiful walk back. Spends the meter for the extra damage too.
V-trigger just worn out, so.
Now that crouch medium. Dumps him and gets a throw.
Not so bad to take the throw against Cammy. She doesn't really get anything off of it.
It's enough. Great play. One round apiece now.
Final round. Fight.
It's a lot slower pace than I would have
thought. Katie opening, I was going to say. Yeah. Straight with the EX.
Oh man, that just slipped behind.
Again, takes the throw. Goes back to neutral.
Great patience there from Goichi and Tex as well.
Nice composure to take that pressure.
That's a significant life deficit though. And cornered as Kazunoko turns it on. Looking to close this one out.
Get the
combo. Nice, great play from Kazunoko. He goes into a 1-0 lead. I mean, it's like, it's so slow that when Kazunoko does that, plays slow and then suddenly switches it on you, you forget he's Kazunoko.
That burst, yeah, exactly.
Very hard to adapt to such a tremendous shift in play.
Goichi's doing well absorbing that pressure, but there's so much of it.
Where can
Goichi interrupt?
We don't want to press too many buttons because she gets so much reward for those counter hits. She's designed to hit you with them and extend them that damage, but she's got to start interrupting some of these strings, I feel.
Yeah, we've seen Goichi take a lot of throws, just doesn't want to get opened up.
Oh, nice. Tries to press a button.
Gets clipped. Back in the corner as well, but gets thrown out. Takes the throw once more. Looked to punish the recovery of that, but...
Kazunoko trying to activate now. He gets it. That crouch fit.
Oh, gets fourth rounded as well.
Big damage! Oh, what a choice from Goichi! What a choice!
Goichi had had enough of that pressure. I like that as well. He absorbed so much pressure over the past four rounds.
It was almost guaranteed. Kazunoko takes his own medicine. Here comes the fiercest. Kami says, I've got one too.
Nice.
Great spacing there.
Short dive kick getting punished in recovery on the landing frame.
Oh, misses me, throw.
When throws get thrown. Have to respect Kami though, she's got that super.
Yeah, I don't want to throw any kick.
Burns the bar.
Gets the back throw too. Gets away with a jump in and another throw. Wins up straight away. Oh, he missed it. Oh, he's gonna get a trip guard, he's gonna get it. That was great play from Goichi. Both of the players making mistakes there. It was Goichi who was able to capitalize in the end.
Tying it up to one game apiece.
Great turnaround.
Chun-Li wins. It's really back and forth stuff, and both of these players are really showing each other a lot of respect. We're not seeing a huge amount of reversals. It almost doesn't look like Kazunoko.
I think maybe this is a guy he plays with a lot, as we saw in the player videos. That could be why he's not playing the usual Kazunoko style we see. Oh man! Lovely dive kick there, but wasn't able to convert. Goichi from here on. That crowd trap just stopping one of her normals.
Activates again, nice jump back.
It's interesting that Kazunoko's never really. Oh, beautiful jump back, light punch. Hit by too many air dive kicks, he's got an answer for it now.
Looking for that activation.
That jumping gets well punished, but he's dealt with the feature a lot better on that occasion than the last few.
Latest EX dive kick.
Oh, great interruption there from Kazunoko. I love that choice of view reversal there to slow it down a little. Another cross cut though. Coming forward, she's got the meters to win this. The next hit will win it for Goichi.
Crouch and medium kick into critical art will take it if he goes for it.
Oh man, Kazunoko's just jumping all over the place.
Nice, I like that use of view reversal.
And that's what I'm talking about. You want to interrupt to stop the momentum. Tried to press a button there in the middle of the string, got counter hit, extended the combo. Great play from Kazunoko. He takes that first round in this third game. Oh, that looked like it was going behind, but it didn't. Beautiful positioning there from Goichi. Gets a throw. Missed his legs again. And it's put him in the corner. It's just the worst thing that could happen. Kept his down charge and was able to anti-air that jump in though. Gets himself out of the corner because of that too. I've noticed Logan that Kazunoko doesn't spend, you know, K-Brad spends a lot of time wanting to hit confirm his activation.
Yeah. To get the I said that early on, he will just throw that hard punch out and activate it straight away.
Oh, what a sequence there from Goichi. Beautiful play. One round apiece. Showing that Chun-Li can rush down too.
She's so good at maintaining those the frame advantage.
I'm still waiting this weekend.
Do it whilst you can.
Someone to block an instant overhead when it's going to kill you against Chun-Li. Everyone's getting hit.
Another cannon strike.
The reversal just to slow things down there as Kazunoko's trying to turn it on. Noichi's blocked a lot and he misses another instant air legs. Wake up, EX Spinning Bird. Counter hit confirmed with the EX legs. Bringing the pressure now. Not afraid to meet the Kazunoko at all.
Oh, interrupts the fierce, and again
misses.
That really hurts as well with 900 health. Oh, and he does get the activation.
Why did he do an instant legs there? Make no sense. From miles away.
Tried to whiff punish that.
Just missed it.
Too slow.
Oh, stomach's there. Wake up jab. Such a tight round.
Oh, the side switch.
And again.
Need to do that?
Wow, he didn't see the medium hit. He was committed to the tap and throw.
Yep.
Didn't matter in the end. Kazunoko takes the 2-1 lead here against Goichi. That was such a tense finish there. Remember, this is the loser's bracket, guys.
One of these will no longer be in the tournament after this game. I mean, Goichi was seeing a number of execution errors, missing enough legs. I mean, it's not the easiest thing to do all the time, but you'd expect, you know, we've seen Goichi do it much more reliably.
Yeah, we've never seen him miss it this much.
No. Nerves on the stage, I guess.
Interestingly enough, even though he won that game, it was him who wanted a minute there. Yes. Sorry, lost that game. He wanted a minute there just to recompose himself. Great trip. Has Kazunoko corner.
There we go. That's what we've been waiting to see.
He's got a few of them.
Air to air is a good answer. I definitely want to see Goichi deal with those dive kicks a lot better, because you can't just keep taking the pressure.
I agree. And there's that jump medium punch, but you've got to be so focused to do that.
Dashes into the legs.
Okay, so that's why he did that legs from miles away earlier. Anticipating a forward dash. It cost him the round last time, but he still did it again.
Got in the round that time.
Now that's when you know two players know each other very well.
It's really important to identify what players' habits are in the neutral.
Yeah, you can get so much reward from a player's tendencies.
So difficult to react to everything, especially against a mobile character like Kami with a dive kick, so having a bit of a read always helps. Maintaining that spacing. It's the air reset. Back dashes after the pressure.
Nice little life lead here for Kazunoko as he decides to slow it down. Going to get something starting there with that fireball, but it was well dealt with by Kazunoko. Trying to get himself to match point.
Kazunoko is really mixing up the jump ins and the dive kicks. Nice play that time. That's like only the second reversal I think I've seen Goichi do.
Such a good block.
Activation coming real soon.
He's got down charge. He could be EX spinning burn those cannon strikes, but he doesn't want to. He doesn't want to spin the meter. And every reversal there from Kazunoko. And these medium kicks. Oh,
a little
play.
A little shimmy.
That was lovely.
And we're going into set point here for Kazunoko.
Full meter as well.
Another really late EX dive kick there.
Another missed legs as well from Goichi. It's been a story in a set for him.
Nice confirm.
Yeah, well placed jab there to interrupt that Kazunoko sequence. Oh, not ready for the cross underneath. This round looking great for Goichi. Going to confirm into the critical art.
This is going to be a very significant life lead, but Kami is going to have a ton of resources. Ooh,
oh, this is
nice. The palm.
One of the most active moves in the game. Sends Kazunoko flying for his wake-up buttons. Great read. Despite the wake-up DPs he got hit with earlier. Just knowing that every now and then Kazunoko will wake up with a jab or something. It's 2-2 now. As we're going to the final game of this set. This is going to
look at that steely glare there on Kazunoko.
Last year's champion.
We saw these two players square off a number of times early on in the season as well. traveling across the world for those first few events.
Now hit there. Tries to meet him in the air, doesn't work.
No real consistent answer to this dive kick pressure. Has to activate yet, presses a jab afterwards, it's zero, so that trades. Ooh, that was a nice time to reversal.
The wake up buttons connects this time.
Missed his throw again.
Oh, the activation paid off. And we're going to set point for Kazunoko.
This could be the end for Goichi.
Keeps throwing out that hard punch at that range. What's he looking for?
It's that approach from Cammy. I think he wants to interrupt.
Like preemptive for a dash, mate?
Yeah, definitely something like that. Maybe a button too. There it is again. This is just playing Chun-Li. They love that button.
The reversal, of course, not a consistent answer for that dive kick, and this pressure is now getting converted into damage.
Kazunoko has played such a lame round.
Life lead for Kazunoko.
This dry style, this mixture between the two has been perfect for Goichi to defeat Goichi.
Well, Goichi's just been letting Kazunoko get away, and another
legs.
Drop legs. And I look to activate.
I'm not good, that's it.
Oh.
Kazunoko gets the cross cut, and he will take it. Punches his fist in the air.
Goichi goes out with a damp squib there. Kazunoko really... I mean, they took it to the end, but it didn't really look like Kazunoko was in a lot of trouble. It kind of seemed like Kazunoko was always dictating what was happening, and it was whether or not Goichi could capitalize on any openings that were presented to him rather than really taking control.
It was nice to see a different approach from Kazunoko. Mm. I think that's quite scary. I mean, let's go back and take a look at some of those moments, Logan. But...
That was, I love that. That was so cheeky.
Massive. First round of the
empty
set.
Jump too low.
Goichi in pole position to take it. Jumps in, especially after all those dive kicks.
Another execution error there. We saw so many of them missed. But
Abel's come out.
He was able to bring it back.
Only because Kazunoko missed the trip guard. Goichi needed to take a minute there. What a moment.
We saw both players successfully baiting reversals. There wasn't a lot of reversals used.
Not from Goichi so much. That cross under was incredible. It looked like it was staying in front. She slipped behind in the last minute. So difficult to block. And this was beautiful. He's going to walk up and just bait that throw. There it is. Goichi lands it pretty.
Lands it. I love that. But in the end.
Oh, man. That wake up activation was a great decision.
In the end, Kazunoko took it. And he advanced.